Hello, welcome to Microsoft Build. My name is Sudhi, and I'm a program manager in the Microsoft Office team. In this session, I'll give a quick introduction about Excel Service APIs in a way that can help your solutions take advantage of Excel's calculation power. I'll walk through a helpful demo and show resources for you to learn and engage. Excel is one of the most popular productivity applications that users rely upon to store and analyze business-relevant data. Excel, being part of Microsoft Graph, plays an important role in the overall Office developer ecosystem. You can create web and mobile apps that reads and writes data to Excel files located in the Office 365 using the web development tools of your choice. Excel REST APIs are available over Drive API and requires files read and write permission to perform operations. The APIs are designed for easy access to objects such as range, table, and charts. So, which Excel files can be accessed? Any Excel files stored on your OneDrive for Business, a SharePoint, a group site can be targeted. We're working hard to support OneDrive consumer platform soon. In short, if you can reach the file using Drive API, you'll be able to access it through the Excel REST APIs. Here are some of the sample API calls. The API supports persistent or write mode and an analysis mode that doesn't save your actions. This is determined by the type of sessions you create. Session APIs are important to help with the performance, so don't forget to use this in your application. Simply pass the value along in a HTTP header. The second sample shows reading of a worksheet collection, and the last sample shows worksheet payment function being called. You can learn a lot more at the Microsoft Graph documentation page and following us on our social channels. Do post your questions on Stack Overflow. Now, I'll switch to our demo to show a sample scenario. This is inspired by a developer question that was posted on Stack Overflow forum regarding the need to read select rows in a table based on a criteria. Well, we provide table filter operations to achieve this scenario. Let's see how this is done. Here, I'm showing an Excel spreadsheet that contains data of cities containing the highest population. It also shows the country and the year in which the population measurements were taken. Now, what if I want to only analyze cities belonging to certain countries? In Excel, you can do that by simply applying filter on the column that you're interested in. If you were to do this using the APIs, there are two ways to do it. One, you can read through each of the rows one by one, and on the client side, apply a filter on the select countries that you wish to operate on. Well, that can be quite taxing, and then it can affect the performance. Excel offers filter APIs, which is the second and probably the better way of doing, which is to apply filter on the columns that you're interested in. This is simply done just as you would do in the UI by applying filter action on the third column, which is the country column. Now I'll switch over to the code just to show how this sample would look like. For one, you would apply values filter, which is an action on the column that you wish to operate on. So you would post simply on the column and call on the filter resource and apply the action values filter by passing the values of countries that you want to filter on. In this case, I've selected two countries and I'm supplying that as an array parameter. And the whole path looks something like this. So I have the Excel file that I'm interested in with the workbook tables collection on the table one, which is the table I'm operating on, and I'm selecting the third column, which happens to be the country column. The ID is value number 3, and I'll apply the apply value filter. Now, let's go to Microsoft Graph Explorer to see how this works. So I'm going to copy this value of the URL and also copy in the JSON body with the filter values, and I'm going to execute this API. I'll switch over to the Excel spreadsheet and refresh, and you'll see that the country filter would have taken effect. Now, this spreadsheet also has year in which the measurement was taken. Now, the user has marked the rows with yellow values in the column year measurement, indicating that the values are somewhat old, because you'll see that anything that was measured recently doesn't have this value, doesn't have this yellow background color. Now, what if you wish to also apply a filter based on the color, just as you would in the UI, the API also allows you to do that. So let's go ahead and do that. And before I do that, I'll show how to actually clear the values, because depending on your scenarios, you may want to apply multiple filter values, or you may want to clear and reapply. In this case, I simply call upon the clear action on the same column, and I will execute that API, and I'll come over and refresh the view, and you'll see that the filter that I had applied on the country will now be removed. Now, let's go ahead and see how the application of cell color filter is applied. Now, the syntax looks very much similar, except in this case, I'm switching to column phi, which is the year column, and I'm calling the apply cell format, cell color filter by calling the yellow color in the JSON body. Now I'm going to copy the actual URL path, showing the whole action path. I'm going to run this query. I'll switch over and refresh the view, and you'll see that only the cells that have yellow color would be filtered out, as it's shown here. Well, all this is great. Now, what if I want to only read the rows where this filter has been applied? And you can do that by reading the underlying range values on the filtered rows. And you can do that by calling upon the visible view function on the underlying range. In this case, I'm applying the visible view function on the range object for the column that I'm interested in. Now, you can also apply this to the entire table and read all the row values. So let's see how this looks like. And unlike in the previous cases, this is a get action. And I'm going to execute this. And you'll see that the returned values, wherein I've selected only the values of the range of the visible rows, and I see only the rows in which the cells were highlighted with the yellow color. Hope this gets you interested in exploring more about Excel APIs. Thank you for watching.